Hey, this is John Fernay, the co-host of the Maryland Crabs, and I am here today with a Maryland crab cake for your listening pleasure. What's a crab cake? It's not quite a full episode. It's just a little snippet. Stay tuned and check it out. And make sure you check us out on themarylandcrabs.com. You can follow us on Twitter at MD Crabs Podcast or find us on Facebook at the Maryland Crabs Podcast. And don't forget, subscribe, rate us, iTunes. Go there now. And we are on the phone with Brad Downs, who is the vice president of marketing for the Baltimore Ravens. And you might want to ask, why are we talking to the Ravens? We talked to them a couple months ago. We talked to Adam Rudell, Heather Darney, and Garrett Downing early, I guess, in the summer before the Ravens came for a camp for the kids in Annapolis. But Brad, you guys are bringing the Ravens to Annapolis again this weekend.
We are. We'll be in Annapolis Friday for a little bit, which we'll touch on. But then Saturday evening at Navy Marine Corps Memorial Stadium, we'll have a training camp practice at 6 p.m. That's free and open to the public for all of our fans down there and in that region that may not always conveniently get to see us during training camp. It's a good opportunity to return to the Naval Academy for a practice as we did a few years ago.
Let's start with Friday, okay? You're painting our town purple.
That's right.
Hopefully you've got the right permits for this, because we're funny about that, you know.
We're working on. We've learned that over the years, John. We've learned that over the years. So we definitely are, we're trying to dot all the I's and cross all the T's, and I think we've got most of them taken care of.
You know, I had to laugh when you guys were in here for the kids camp about a month ago. You did something similar, and there were a lot of, washable stencils put on the sidewalks with the Purple Raven. With spray chalk or whatnot. And there were several comments on some neighborhood Facebook posts and stuff like that from the crusty old people, like, what is this graffiti? Do we have gangs? And I'm like, oh, are you serious? Yeah. gang of Ravens coming. Come on.
Yeah. So, John, it is interesting. You know, those purple stencils we started doing when we were fortunate enough to have several playoff runs in a row and some long playoff runs, and we would always start in Baltimore, and then each week that we would advance, we'd go to some of our more suburban areas, our outlying areas of our territory. And what was so easy and welcomed in Baltimore direct, we learned quickly that we definitely have to check all the boxes on approvals to do that.
So that's funny.
Leave it at that for now, but we're well aware of that. Some people aren't necessarily a fan of seeing our temporary stencils down there.
Oh, you know, they're probably like Steeler fans or Redskins fans, so we don't care about them. So just, you know.
Right, that's right. Exactly.
They don't care. They don't care. Well, what's happening on Friday? You guys are bringing the bus and Poe and cheerleaders and whatnot down to City Dock at 11 o'clock, I hear.
That's right. So we've got our Purple Friday caravan. So we celebrate Purple Fridays really all year and encourage our fans to wear purple on Fridays. And throughout the year, we do a few different events on Purple Friday. And we thought, what a perfect opportunity to bring our Purple Friday caravan to Annapolis this Friday to generate even more excitement prior to our practice on Saturday. So, yeah, we'll have our Ravens-branded bus that will travel to a few locations on Friday morning. We're going to start at an appearance that's closed to the general public, but we're going to stop by the Pitt Moyer Recreation Center for some kids camps, and we'll have our cheerleaders, our mascot, our pep band with us. And then we head over to City Dock at 11 a.m. approximately, and then around noon we'll end our morning caravan at Wiseman Park.
Okay, and Wiseman Park is kind of a weird park that nobody knows the name of, but this is the little small park across from the Ram's Head on West Street, and it's adjacent to the Visit Annapolis, or the Convention and Visitors Bureau, as it used to be called.
Exactly, yeah.
And right in the heart of historic downtown Annapolis. And again, you said you're going to have the band and the cheerleaders, and was Poe going to be there?
Poe is going to be there, absolutely.
That leads into Saturday.
Right, and we'll have some fun giveaways on the caravan and some things like that for our fans down there. So, you know, we always try to have everyone leave with something. We don't want anybody to leave empty-handed. So,
you're giving away season tickets. Is that what I heard you say? We have a bad connection.
I didn't go that far, John. I didn't go that far. So we'll have some fun in store.
Well, that's good. On Saturday, though, is the big day, and I'm curious as to how Navy's going to pull this off, because they've got their fan festival day, or their fan fest that morning, as well as media day for Navy football. Then you guys move in the afternoon for a practice. And you've done this, you did this for 3 years, and then there's been a 2 year hiatus.
Exactly.
And now you're back. So what's this all about? Sort of refresh our memory on this. I know you're bringing the family zone or the fun zone. And then obviously you've got the practice.
Yeah. So we try to do, you know, it's really like a big fan fest that we try to bring along with us for these stadium practices. You know, it's really, you know, we try to have everybody leave just having a good time. We have a lot of interactives for the kids. We've tried to do something for everybody. We have some autograph areas with our alumni players who will be in attendance. But yeah, you know, back to your earlier point, we practiced at Navy in 2012, 13, and 14. And then the way the schedules changed in 15 and 16, we weren't able to make it with the training camp schedules. They've abbreviated the ability, the practice schedules so much that, you know, it really does benefit to stay at our facility, which is why we're at our facility now for training camp. You know, we just felt like it was time to go back this year at a perfect opportunity. We can't host any fans at our facility this year due to renovations. So we're excited to come back, and we'll have a lot of activities going on around practice. We'll do some fun things on the video screens. But yeah, it'll be a little bit of a tight turnaround with the Navy event in the morning, but the folks at the stadium and at the Naval Academy have been so, so helpful and excited to have us there that it's been great to work with those guys for sure.
Well, it is. I remember when you first came here, Steve Viscotti had said that he would like to make this an annual thing just because he's got a connection to Anne Arundel County, Annapolis. I go over the Eastport Bridge and I see his boat there all the time. I go down there a couple times and they never let me on. I don't understand what the problem is, but
same with me, John. Don't worry about it.
Okay, so it's not me. That's good. That's good.
No.
Well, I remember in 2014 we had so much fun with this. Torrey Smith was on the sideline and he grabbed some kid's camera and did a selfie with him. And my photographer had a picture of him snapping the selfie. And then we went out to social media and we said, I want the opposite picture. I want a copy of the selfie. And somebody had followed us and sent it there. So it was really kind of cool. We put them both back to back. Here's the picture of them. And it was really kind of neat. But it was the kids have a great time with this.
It's really a fun night. And if you may have seen, you know, we did at our first stadium practice this past Sunday here, we did a dance cam, a Brandon Williams dance cam. And you may have seen the video. It kind of went viral a little bit after the fact, but you know, it's training camp, so the players, there are opportunities for the players to really engage with the fans that you don't normally get in the season. So, you know, see Brandon Williams having an impromptu dance off with our winner in the stands, a young girl in the stands, was pretty entertaining.
Oh, that's great.
It even made its way on the Sports Center, believe it or not.
There you go. Well, I remember that, you know, obviously you've got the alumni players doing in, you're doing some, you know, meet and greets, and the cheerleaders and whatnot are all going to be there. Are you going to bring all the inflatables and all that as well?
Yep. We'll have inflatables. We'll have some of our normal football inflatables, and then a few other, you know, new interactives. We're testing some virtual reality football, some things like that. You know, we did just add, we've got a great lineup of alumni, as you mentioned, which I'll touch on quickly. We've got former Colt great Tom Maddie. You know, it's a great opportunity for us to bring the former Colts out because we know what an impact they had on the community. And then former Ravens Jermaine Lewis and Vontae Leach. And then we just found out that Ed Reed will be joining us as well. So we've got quite a lineup of alumni guys who will be there to interact with the fans.
That's great. And I will say, as far as the fan interaction goes, in years past, and hopefully they're going to be doing it again this year, but after the practice is over. I mean, and they do a practice. I mean, this isn't just a, you know, meet and greet for the team down in Annapolis. They do a practice, but after the practice is over, players, all the players, the current ones, were just so gracious as far as coming over to the side of the field, signing autographs, taking pictures, you know, high fives, whatever it is. And it was just so wonderful for the kids to see them, you know, hanging over the side, just looking at their heroes on do that. And I hope they do that again.
Yeah, we certainly are. And as you mentioned, this is a regular training camp practice. This isn't a different version. It's very serious preparation for the season, as you know what training camp is, and then we will have the post practice autographs for the kids and for military, because it is, you know, we are featuring some military appreciation activities, so we'll have our full squad that'll be signing autographs for kids and interacting with our military members who attend as well.
What time does this all get underway on Saturday? Five.
The gates open at 5 o'clock on Saturday, and practice will get underway right around 6 p.m.
Okay, and there will be parking at Navy Marine Corps Memorial Stadium. And as typical with the Navy, I'm pretty sure there's probably going to be a fee to park, if I'm not mistaken.
Yeah, it's a $10 fee to park, cash only, but admission is free for the evening.
Are you going to have it set up pretty much the same way where the fun zone, if you will, is out back underneath the scoreboards and adjacent to that within the field, and then the practice is obviously on the field, right?
Exactly. All of our interactive activities will be out in that north end behind the memorial. So it's kind of nice to have everything in one place, and then once practice is really underway, you know, back onto the field, obviously, for that. And then immediately following practice, we'll invite all the kids down to the first couple rows, and our players will be excited to say hello to them and sign autographs and take pictures as best as they can.
It's funny. I was talking to Jamie Costello from ABC2 yesterday, and we're going to connect there on Saturday as well. And I believe that he's bringing his new baby for his first Ravens exposure.
Oh, so, very nice.
So little baby Gio will get his first taste of Ravens.
Excellent. It's definitely a family-friendly event for sure. So we're looking forward to seeing a lot of kids out there and, you know, a lot of fans. You know, we try to do a little bit of something for everyone. So we're excited to be there for sure. Annapolis is a really important area for us. And so the more we can reach our fans down there, the better.
Hey, let me put you on the spot a little bit here. I mean, the buzzword of the week or a couple of weeks has been Kaepernick. And yeah. I know that you're the VP of marketing for the Ravens, so you obviously are not involved with the player personnel or anything like that. ESPN's been reporting that both Ozzie Newsome and John Harbaugh are looking to, you know, sign essentially an insurance policy because Flacco's got some injuries there. Does the controversy surrounding Kaepernick impact you as far as marketing the team and whatnot? I mean, I look at Michael Vick coming out of Atlanta, and I remember Jeffrey Lurie had basically said, okay, I'm going to take a chance on you, but if I see one drop in revenue, whether it be ticket sales or concessions, I'm going to blame it on you and release you. And that's what I had heard. I don't know how true that is, but is that going to be a problem for marketing if Kaepernick were to be signed with the Ravens?
You know, it's hard to tell. You know, we're clearly, you know, getting feedback from our fans, and you know, I'm not involved in the discussions on personnel moves, and obviously never am. But, you know, our owner's spoken on the topic at length, and, you know, obviously our head coach has. So, you know, I think it's just a matter of we'll see how it plays out. And, you know, from a marketing and fan standpoint, there's certain situations that happen, and we'll work with our fans and continue to engage with our fans and do our best to, you know, maintain our fans as best as we can, like we would in any situation like that. So, you know, we're just letting the situation play out, certainly on the football side, as that's all, you know, a decision that they'll come to, and then we'll go from there. So, you know, I don't really know much more than what everybody's heard in the media. So, you know, so that's kind of where we're at from a marketing standpoint.
Well, you've got to roll with the punches, I imagine. And to be honest with you, I guess from a football standpoint, with Joe Flacco and his injured back, without knowing where the future goes, I mean, it probably does make sense to have, you know, a solid backup to do that, whether it's the right person or not. I guess that's to be seen. And that'll be seen, I guess, at the end of the season as we go into the playoffs.
Yeah, I mean, you know, hopefully Joe's good. I know the reports are that everything's progressing nicely with him, and, you know, hopefully all of this is a moot point one way or the other.
That'd be nice. Okay, so now, as you're walking around the Under Armour Performance Center, you hear any scuttlebutt on the season? I mean, I know you're not involved in this. I mean, what's the outlook for the season?
You know, just generally, everybody's really excited about a lot of our young guys that we drafted, and you know, getting them in there with our vets for camp. You know, I'm not, we're because of the renovation, we're at the stadium, so I don't get to watch as much of practice as I normally would. Not that I get to watch a ton, but I know there's a buzz in the building about a lot of these young guys that we got, and getting them mixed in with the, you know, Terrell Suggs of the world and some of our veteran leaders. And so we're, you know, as an organization, we're excited about the season and looking forward to getting on the field as quick as possible.
Well, I know the fans are. Got several of my friends on Facebook and Twitter.
Yeah, you know,
have the countdown, and just can't wait until football season starts, which is for sure, though.
The fans are so passionate. I mean, to see those count, I love seeing those countdowns, because, I mean, listen, I've worked work for the team, but I'm as big a football fan as it gets as well. And
where are you from?
Be a fan and can't always be a fan in this role, but what's that, John?
Where are you from?
I grew up in Western Maryland, in Williamsport, Maryland, right near Hagerstown, if you're familiar with that. So I'm a Maryland guy, you know.
But you had the potential to be a Steelers fan.
It's funny out there. You know, at the time I grew up, it was as the Colts were leaving, a lot of fans out there went to the Steelers. I did not, and we're currently trying to bring all those fans back to the Baltimore side. And we've made some progress in Western Maryland. You know, you touched on the clinic that we did in Annapolis. We've done those in some of our further reaching areas of our marketing territory. So our philosophy is to engage with as many fans as possible and, you know, bring them on board as a Ravens fan. So yeah, that area I grew up in is definitely, you know, went Steelers somewhat, because if you're aware, you know, when the Colts left, it was not a, you know, the Colts and Redskins had a bit of a rivalry. So, you know, people, yeah, I think would go to the Steelers out there before they went to the Redskins. But, you know, over the years, it's kind of a mixing bowl out there in Western Maryland where I grew up. So when I go visit my family, you know, I always pay attention to what colors I see out there. And it's kind of a sense of pride for me. The more purple I see out there, I'm really happy about, for sure.
We'll call that hashtag winning, right?
That's right. But, that's right.
Well, I know Adam said that when they went out west, that he was somewhat but pleasantly surprised at how well the Ravens were received out there, knowing that it is a good portion of it is Steeler country. So that's good.
Yeah.
That there's, you know, statewide support of this. And certainly I know you have it down here in Annapolis. I know we get a little bit south of Route 50. Then we sort of get into Redskins territory, but that's kind of interesting. But I do want to thank you, Brad Downs, Vice President of Marketing for the Baltimore Ravens, to tell us all about Purple Friday happening, as well as the practice at Navy Marine Corps Memorial Stadium on Saturday with the alumni Ravens, as well as the current Ravens out on the field. You know, great to talk to you. Great to get some little bit of insight.
Great.
And I'll tell you, after the season, here's your homework for the next 18 weeks. I want to talk to either Steve Bisciotti or John Harbaugh off season. Can you make that happen for me?
Well,
come on, put a plug in for me. I just lost him. Unbelievable. That's great. Well, that was Brad Downs, Vice President of Marketing from the Baltimore Ravens. I don't know whether he hung up on me and said, yeah, I'm not going here.
Oh. I lost you for a second there, John, but you're back.
I thought I lost you. It was funny. I said, okay, well, I guess that answers that question.
No, I said, I'll see what I can do. No guarantees, but I'll see what I can do.
Wonderful. Well, again, Brad Downs, Vice President of Marketing for the Baltimore Ravens. Thank you very much for your time this morning. Good luck for the season. Will you be out there on Saturday?
Absolutely. I will be out there Saturday, and looking forward to seeing all the fans out there, and we're going to have a lot of fun for sure. So I appreciate you having me on, John.
I will hunt you down, and I'll introduce myself when I'm there.
Please do. Please do.
All right. Take care, Brad. Thank you.
You too, John. Thank you.
Bye-bye.
This has been the Maryland Crabs Podcast with Tim Hamilton and John Fernay. Sure to follow them in all the regular places, Facebook, Twitter, YouTube, and online at themarylandcrabs.com. Take a moment to rate us on iTunes. Now, get the hell out of my kitchen. Seriously, go!
You're still here? It's over. Go home. Go.